true doctrine of Yahweh Shai. Okay? Who we out here for? Don't have the signs out because of the wind. But you Israelites, you so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and you Native Indians, okay? Come out here to wake you up, the elect of you, all right? The rest of you are going to die in America, two-thirds of you. And who are the Israelites once again? You Negroes, Hispanics, and you Native Indians, man. By the line of your fathers. Okay? We came on this side of the world, America became Babylon, to serve out our slavery. However, captivity is coming to an end. That's why you got all these prophecies that's happening week in and week out. What are some of the prophecies? Because Jake is hard hit, so you have to remind him. The economy, man, about to crumble. With that, you're going to have automatic famine. With that, you're going to have martial law. Okay? The holy state. Like we keep telling you, your civil liberties and the things that your privileges that you like doing, you're going to lose it, man. This is going to be a chaotic state when the economy crashes. With that, you're going to have race riots. On top of that, you're going to have what? The RFID chip. Revelations, the 13th and 14th chapter, which is going to be the new currency, digital. Blow the trumpet to warn Jake. Obviously, we know that the majority of our people is not going to receive it, man. But the beautiful thing is that this word, it goes out on the internet throughout the globe. Okay? Most high sealing the elect. And the number one this week is this football player is not saluting the American flag. Man, we told you racial tension was coming to America, man. And you know you got that wicked-ass parade on Monday. You West Indians and you Levites, you Benjamites and you Levites, you're going to be into that damn carnival. Okay, that's the two-thirds club, man. It is a hurricane coming and you still going to go out there and act as a fool. But that's the most high people. And that's why two-thirds of them are marked for death. Okay, we just come out here and get the blood off our hands. Chapter 39, verse 1. We in a time of prophecy, man. We're supposed to be preaching week in and week out. It's prophecy. Okay, we don't got time to be playing games with Jake, man. We're not in the time of prospering. Okay, trying to make it in this society. That's vanity. Because America's falling, man. Ecclesiastes 39, verse 1. It says, But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High, which the law, statutes, and commandments was never done away with. Okay, we under liberty. I mean, we under grace and mercy, which is a time period for Israel to get the act together. Within the meantime, I'm looking at part of you coming back to who you are, you got to rehearse the righteous acts. Like, Lord willing, next week, which I won't be out here next week. I won't be out here next week because of the Day of Atonement. Friday night to Saturday, September 9th to September 10th. Friday night to Saturday night is a 24-hour fast. Okay? I'm going to go into that later on. Okay, it's going to be a fast. That's a high holy day. Yes, you're supposed to still keep the high holy day. But right after that will be the feast of tabernacles. That's a part of keeping the laws of the Most High. Also, we're not keeping it as perfect as we can, but we're rehearsing everything. Okay, until we so read it. Ecclesiastes 39 and 1. But he that giveth his mind to the law of the Most High, and is occupied in the meditation thereof, will seek out the wisdom of all the ancient. It's through the scriptures. This is the wisdom of the ancient. That's why it says Romans 15 and 4, that things are written aforetime, written for our learning. To read through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. These are the records of our forefathers, man. That's seeking out the knowledge of the ancient. We ain't supposed to be seeking out the knowledge of America. Because the knowledge of wickedness is not knowledge, man. It says, and be occupied. What does the Bible say? I'm going to read it again. And be occupied in prophecies. So we're supposed to be occupied in prophecies. What does the word prophecy mean? Pro means before. Foresee means to say or to tell. To say before. What are we supposed to be prophesying? The downfall of America. The downfall of Babylon. Because the way it was built was unjust. It was built on rape, robbery, and murder. Because it has the greatest people. You saw called the people of the Native Indians. The lost 12 tribes and the children of Israel. Everything that you learn in this society was one of your lies. Starting with that white image of Jesus Christ. That's a damn lie. That's the greatest lie ever told. Columbus, man, who's right across the street. Big talk. You know what I'm saying? He was another one. One of the main missionaries pushing that doctrine, man. But we at the end now. The truth is already out. That Christ is black and so is the people. Okay? So, yes. We're supposed to be occupied in prophecies. All you other Israelite groups that I see online partying, dancing. So I'm saying, what are you dancing for? We not in the kingdom, man. We got a lot of work to do, man. Alright, that's what the Lord said. I'm going to read Luke the 10th chapter. You got dudes singing and dancing on the Passover, man. That's disgraceful, man. Okay? We'll sing in the kingdom. Alright, right now we got to warn our people because death is coming. Destruction is coming, man. It's going to be a famine of the word. Alright? Luke the 10th chapter. So maximize your liberty. Alright? And doing the right thing. Luke the 10th chapter. It says, after these things the Lord appointed other 70 also, and sent them two and two before his face into every city and place whither he himself would come. Therefore said he, come unto them. The harvest truly is great. The harvest is great. What's the harvest? The work. Okay? This is a great work being, man. This is a great work. Alright? Sealing up the 12 tribes or the house of David. Okay? Bringing the preachers together, man. That's the work that he sent his apostles, the disciples at that time to do. Was to gather the lost sheep and to tell them that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. I'm going to read it again. After these things, the Lord appointed other 70 also and sent them two and two before his face into every city and place whither he himself would come. Therefore he said unto them, the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. It's a few laborers, man. You got a lot of men who have the knowledge who's sitting on it. What are you sitting on your talents for, man? See, this is wickedness. This is wicked as hell, man. See, that proves that we in America, man. But like I said before, why you sitting on your talents, man? If you have this knowledge, you know who you are, you have that gift of prophecy, you can break down the scriptures, you got to go out there and prophesy. You got to build on it. All right? Because you are going to receive a reward. But you got to be patient and wait. All right? He said, pray therefore the Lord of the harvest that he would send forth laborers into the harvest, man. Pray to Most High, he sent forth more laborers. Because the more brothers wake up, it's the quicker we get out of here. Okay? Yahweh Shai, what you hate to call Jesus Christ, is waiting for the 144,000 to wake up, which are the rulers of the world to come. Alright? Underneath Yahweh Shai, the 12 apostles, man. We're waking up the 144,000, which is scattered throughout the globe, man. That's why this word goes out on the internet, man. Okay? That's the main way that I woke up, man, was through what? Through the internet, man. You got a lot of negativity out there on the internet, but you got a lot of what? That's how this message spread. So this word, it backfired on Esau, man. That's why Esau, they came up with a law. They gonna start monitoring your content on YouTube. If anybody say anything that's politically incorrect, you can't monetize your videos. Which we don't monetize our videos anyway. We don't make money off this thing, man. Okay? Like I said, we receive our reward in the world to come. Alright? But the Most High, Yahweh Shai, said that the work is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Okay? And that goes exactly to what I want to talk about right now. Because you got dudes out there that's getting weak. Okay? You don't want to get sifted in this thing, man. The way you stay on point is by studying, man. And producing, being prolific. If you're too idle in this truth, Satan is going... That's how these demons get you, man. Because he's always looking for a way to exploit your weaknesses. That's what he's set up to do. To take what you have. Which is this truth, man. Alright, so I'm going to get some scriptures, man. First one, Colossians 3:23. Guys do this what's the word I'm looking for? Deceitfully. have to keep fighting then. Okay, this is a long place of endurance. A lot of guys, they started out on fire, started sprinting ahead of the pack, and they started getting tired. They started getting weak. Right? I'm remembering to read that Bible. Mark the 4th chapter. All the way now, man. After not saluting the flag, God told a white man he's a devil, man, and that his society is gonna go down. And that's the spirit that you black men and Hispanic men and you Native Indian men. That's the spirit you're supposed to be in anyway. You're supposed to salute that flag, man. That flag is wickedness, man.
Native Americans don't salute anyway because they're on reservations.
Yeah, you on reservations? Like you got this guy with the American seat. That's a silly Jake, man. Hispanic. With some fucking flag on, so excuse my language, you know what I'm saying? With some flag on his t-shirt, that's the spirit. So as we talk about it, man, showed up. Of some flag on your t-shirt, man. Celebrating your captivity. Glorifying your presence. Is a guilt conscience.
That's right, man.
We standing on Native American bones right now.
That's right. The spirits are talking, bro.
Starting with Columbus, man. Put the camera on this guy, man. Real quick. Okay? That's Columbus across the street. That's who the white man... Look. He got his own statue. Like, he's... Right? So, like I said, we got no business saluting that flag, man. That's the spirit our people should have been in anyway. See what I'm saying? Because that's all... And a lot of these on Jake's in the entertainment world and sports arena know that. A lot of them see us online. A lot of them waking up. Because you're only entertainment to the white man. That's the only reason why he give you all the millions of dollars. Because he know nobody could compete with you on that level. Because we're the salt of the earth. All you are, you just nothing but mere entertainment to these Edomites, man. Just like you were back in ancient Rome, in the Colosseums. Those were Jakes, those were gladiators, man. When you go into Spartacus, those were Jakes, man. Like we keep telling you, the black Greeks, the people that Paul was trying to convert, that's what Paul even gave you your mouth. Are those who run the race, who are to receive the prize? If you're doing this not wholeheartedly, it's like you boxing in a... Remember that scripture? He's like one that beat it for him. But he's known as a boxer, man. Those were Jakes back then that dominated the Olympics, that dominated the Olympics. And it's the same story again. Okay, there's nothing new under the sun. Everything is reincarnated. You see what I'm saying? And a lot of them now are starting to wake up because of this truth, man. Ecclesiastes chapter 38. If they learn it. your talent may be, because every brother has different gifts. When you read 1 Corinthians, the 12th chapter, every brother was given a different measure of the Spirit. Some good guys are good in prophesying. Some guys are good in the history. Some guys are good in speaking different languages. Some guys make the garments. Some guys do the artwork and make the signs for brothers. Okay? Some guys do other videos online, man. Some guys are good in health, herbs. It's different offices. So whatever your office is, you just got to know and maximize it. So the Most High said what? I'm going to read it. Ecclesiastes 38:24. The wisdom of a learned man cometh by the opportunity of leisure. For him when his spirit... No. And he that hath little business shall become wise, man. Yeah. Because you are supposed to work. That's just... Scripture said you don't work, you don't eat. Alright? But if you work too much, you can't do this work. You work 7 days a week. How's the word of the Lord going to go out, man? What did the Lord tell me? If you love me, feed my sheep. I told him that 3 times. That's the only way you can make it out of this thing. You're not going to make it just bigger. It's about the words of the kingdom. You got to work. You got to work to receive this kingdom. Proverbs 6:6 is what's the kingdom. Follow the rulership of these heathens. The cool brother. The Edomite. The Israelite. The Hamite. Okay? All these heathens outside of the world tribes. That's your reward. Whatever your heart is trying to attain, he's going to give it to you. As we said, I love you guys so much, I'm going to share it with you, man. Your joint is with your heart shine. That's why you have to suffer for his sake. Alright? Scripture says the triumph of the wicked just work for a moment. But we're supposed to work, man. Scripture says if you have leisure time, that's how you work. Yeah, a lot of guys, when they have leisure time, the number one treasure is these wicked people. Those are the two things that sit guys out of the way. Women and money. 90% of the time, the reason why guys pull out the people, if he comes with some money or his job, he don't want to be seen when he's getting the wrong space and while there. You know what I'm saying? He gets a better job, so he has less. Eventually, and his main priority, like he said, my will is to him the will of him that sent you, and to finish his work. And what's the Most High's work? Yahweh's work? Gathering his men. Okay? Another precept, Proverbs 6:6. Okay? Your number one priority is this truth. And everything else falls in second place. Run. The answer to the hand. You learn a lot from looking at a hand. Even though it's small and if it seems minute, it can crush easily. The ant's worth ethic is legendary, man. Something that small can build something that's so great, man. Yup. Build it for its queen, its kingdom, man. And everybody knows their role. So we gotta build for the Most High. Yahweh Shah, man. Gather his men. Proverbs 6:6. Let's read. It says, go to the ant, thou sluggard. Consider her ways and be wise. And again, scripture says what? Proverbs 6 and 6. It says, go to the end. So Solomon is telling me, go observe the end. Go thou what? Thou sluggard, man. You lazy brothers, man. Okay? Like, you got niggas ain't gonna get this thing, man. You niggas gonna be destroyed, man. See, that's a two-third club right there.
So you follow that again. That end 24/7
end. Yup.
He never sleeps. He told you, where we can go and he won't never have to sleep. The sun is never gonna leave us. We're never gonna be tired.
Guys, when we came into this, you made an oath to Yahawah Yahushua that you would stay in it until the end. There is no such thing as coming into this and falling out. That's not even in your mind, man. And it's no way Yahawah is going to let you get away with that. You learned the secrets. You know what 99.9% of people don't know when you came into this knowledge, man. You know the secret of... We know what's going to happen to this country blow by blow, according to these scriptures. You know our history. We know who Esau is. We know these other nations, who they are according to the Bible. We understand the economic system. We understand the white man's secret societies, man. Okay, the wise men of Edom. We know all their secrets. You learn about true diet and herbs when you read the scriptures, man. An alcoholic doctor. All that stuff you learn in the church, you don't learn that in the church. You don't learn that in the world. The world don't teach you that. The world and you understand the true breakdown of these scriptures, man. The world teach that Jesus is white. The world teach that Christ came for everybody. That's what the world teaches, man. The world teach that a church is a building, man. The world teaches that Mary was a virgin, man. The world teaches that the kingdom of heaven is for everybody. The world teaches when you die, you're going to burn in hell, man. That's what these mad religions teach. We see through all of that because we have the truth. Above all, we have the Most High's name and His Son's name. And that's a key part of your salvation. Okay, His name is not God in Christ. Oh, Yahweh and Jehovah, that's not His name. The Father's name is Yahawah and the Son's name is Yahushua. You're not supposed to take those names away. Okay? That's another hidden gem that we came into the knowledge of. The name. Your name, your nationality, the secrets of the times. Okay, you learn the law, statutes, and commandments, which keeps you on a straight and narrow path. Because without that, you're going to be a sodomite, you're going to be an adulterer, you're going to be a thief, you're going to be a murderer, you're going to eat pork, shrimp, crab, lobster, whatever madness I'm going to do, man. Follow the ways of Edom. Okay? Another precept. Proverbs 30, verse 25. So this truth is there's nothing like. Okay? This is a very good thing. I also have to come into the benefits of it yet. Works on its own time. Alright? And now you're supposed to be more joyful than ever because you can see the prophecies happen. Alright? You see prophecies happen every week. Alright? Proverbs 30, 25. Only a fool can't see that a race war is not coming to America. That race war is brewing. Ever since Obama went up in there, racial tension has been increasing. Okay, it's at an all-time high. To the point now where they don't even want to salute the flag. Okay? A racial divide, man. Anyway, let me read that precept. Proverbs 30:25. Jim says this. Another analogy on the ant. The ants are people, not strong. They're not strong. You can crush an ant easily. But they're preparing their meat for the summer. Meaning that what? They're preparing for the winter time, man. So they get everything ready. So now, what is that analogy for us? He's always working and building. An ant is what? He's diligent. Okay? So how is that important to us? If you know you're living in the end, and you know destruction is coming, the scripture says you're supposed to be in all holy convocation, holy conversation, hastening the day, being on fire, man. That's what the scripture says. Make your calling and election sure, and if you do these things, you shall never fail. That's why Solomon wanted to hear. Because he's diligent. Even though he's small and I knew, he's a diligent creature. And he's always working. Okay, that's why I pulled those scriptures. See, we always forever learning in this truth. This truth is living water. You gotta grow in this thing. Alright? That's what the scripture says in Revelation chapter 3. Revelation chapter 3 verse 12. Because we already know Esau will be destroyed and America will be destroyed. But the main part of this truth, you gotta keep examining yourself. That's the number one fight, is yourself, man. Because the prophecy is gonna happen anyway. Regardless. Alright? We just wanna be on the right hand and not the left. We don't wanna be like Saul. Which that spirit was taken away from him. Okay? And that's a good prayer to say on the Day of Atonement, Psalms the 51st chapter. David said, "I cannot try hard. I'm not like Holy Spirit." Okay? That's a scary thing. Revelation chapter 3, verse 12. That's what Yahweh Christ said. "Him that overcometh will I make in the temple of my power. He shall go to the power. And I will write upon it the name of my power. And the name of the city of my power, which is the new Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my power. And I will write upon it my new name." Which, what it means new, means made afresh. Okay? New Jerusalem. It's talking about the 144,000. Okay, when we come down, we're going to get beat up.
That's going to be the ushering of the kingdom.
Okay? So read on. It says, "He that has an ear, let him hear. The Spirit say unto the churches, unto the angel of the church of the Lacedaemonians write, these things save upon the faithful and true witness, the beginning of the creation of the Most High. I know of thy works, that thou art neither cold nor hot." That's what the Lord said. "I know your works." So the Lord sees everything, man, that we do. Alright? "I will not thou work cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm, and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth." So any brother that's lukewarm, he's going to take it. Okay, that's what Yahweh tried to say. Means you're cast out. You're outside of the congregation. And if you're cast out, that means you're in the congregation of the dead. And I'm going to read a precept to happen to a brother that do get cast out. "Sayest, I am rich and increased with goods." That's all that's over to himself. That's all to his job. That's all to these women. The world. Alright? "Have need of nothing and knowest not. Thou art rich and miserable and poor and blind and naked."
Amen.
Alright? says, so then because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of thy mouth. So we don't want that to happen to us. And I'm going to read a scripture. What happens to you when you get spewed out? Matthew 22. Read this. Matthew chapter 22, verse 9. This is what the Lord said. This is a commandment. Go ye therefore into the highways, and as many as ye find, bid to the marriage. The marriage is what? Yahweh Shai joining us back to the Father as the mediator. Started with the 144,000 for the first fruits. Okay? We gonna taste the kingdom first, Lord willing. The highways and hedges. Chief place of concourse. Like jobs and businesses. All that reality is coming from here. That's what you're supposed to do. Get Israel to the marriage. Okay. And the internet does the rest as well. It says, read it. So these servants went out into the highways and gathered together all as many as they found. Both bad and good. Alright, some brothers are good and most are bad. Alright. It says, and the wedding was furnished with guests. We're gonna read on. When the king came in to see the guests, who's the king? Yahweh Shai. He saw their man had not on his way. And he said unto him, friend, how camest thou hither not having any way? The king to the servant, bind him hand and foot, and take him away, and cast him into utter darkness. He shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Many are called, but few are chosen. Weeping and gnashing of teeth later. It don't matter if you laugh or not. You know what I'm saying? We working out our own salvation. Isaiah 61 and 10. I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my power. He hath clothed me with the garments of salvation. So that's the garment that wicked servant didn't have in Matthew 2nd chapter. He's going to be saved. Alright, he's going to get burned up. Lord, my soul will be joyful in my mouth. We have both of the promises of nature. said, if you lukewarm, you in that spirit, rebuke that demon. Okay? You gotta be fervent, man. Like Elisha asked Elijah to give him a double portion of his spirit. Alright? Pray for that. Okay? Pray for the Most High to give you the strength to endure what's about to come on the planet Earth. Because we all gonna need it, man. Our faith has to be maximized during that time. Because if it's not, you're gonna fall. Alright? Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10. It says, whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is a work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the way thou goest. I'm gonna read that again. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10. While you are alive, while there's breath in your lungs, praise the Most High with all thy strength. So I'm gonna read that precept. Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 10. Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do it with thy might. For there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whether thou goest. Okay, you can't praise the Most High in the grave, man. Okay? Jesus says, Yahweh is not a God of the dead, but the living. Okay? So while you're alive, do his work. Okay? You're going to attain everything. Okay? So far, celebrities are sucked out. See, they receive their reward right now. Their constellation is now. Alright? They receive their constellation now. You see, now they start losing now. Demon right there. May the Most High kill that old nigga. He just did what he did. Alright.